Missing 12, something's missing in here. Thank you. City of angels, but we can build a city. So this year I've been looking at multiple aspects of sound design and how they relate to technical theater. And in particular, I've been looking at digital sound design, where you go online and find the sound effects you're looking for and program them on a computer. But I've also been looking at live sound design, where you create your own sound effects to fit the sound that you're looking for. And so for the play The Haunted Hill House, which is adapted for the stage by F. Andrew Leslie, and it's based off the short story by Shirley Jackson, it's a haunted house story. And there's several characters, and they're in this haunted mansion, but they never actually understand fully what the haunting is, and they don't actually know if it's real. It could just be logical explanations. And that's one of the reasons I decided to go with a live Foley sound design for this, because these are logical explanations for the sounds they're hearing. So, live sound design started really when there weren't computers. When you needed the sound of a rock, you threw a rock. And so, what I've done here is I've created a soundscape for what I pictured, how I pictured those sounds, and really I created them in order to best reflect sort of that logical nature, again, of the play. So in order to create the environment, which is the first thing I want to start with, because those would really be the basis of the rest of the sounds, I started with the wind, because like all haunted house tales, it's always a dark, stormy night. And in order to create the wind, what I did is I built this wind machine. And beneath the fabric is a cylinder of 2x4s. And as those 2x4s rotate, they rub against the fabric. And that friction creates a whirring sound. And I'll demonstrate that here. And so that high-pitched whirring sound sort of represents that cold, biting wind that you don't really want to be a part of, so you take shelter inside. And another thing to create the environment is rain, because again, it's a dark, stormy night and it's always pouring. And so to do that, I took plastic BB pellets. I spent a lot of time deciding, do I want to go plastic, do I want to go metal? And ultimately, I decided on plastic BB pellets on a metal paint tray, where you put paint for a paint roller. And I'll demonstrate what that sounds like too. So the way that works is that within the paint tray, there are bumps that you use to rub paint onto the paint roller, but as the BBs roll down, they either skip over it or they bounce between them, and that creates the effect of rain hitting the roof or the window because it's coming in so hard. And that further adds to the colder, the biting winds, to make it sort of a harsh environment. And one last thing for the environment, to create thunder, it's common practice to take what they call a thunder sheet. And what this is it's a piece of galvanized sheet metal, and you hit it with something. And what I did was I took a drumstick with a padded head to sort of make a lower, deeper, more ominous sound. And when you hit it, it creates that boom of thunder. And I'll demonstrate that. And so with the three of those working in tandem, we create that environment of sort of uncomfort, discomfort. And we sort of want to take refuge from that in a haunted house that maybe isn't so safe after all. Another sound effect is a door. So really there wasn't much of a need to recreate the wheel here. So what we did was we took a door that we weren't using in the scene shop and we just cut it down and built a frame to make it more manageable, let's say. And so what this does is it lets us make knocking sounds, which they hear, or even slamming. And one last sound effect that I used the door for is there's one scene where they describe there's a noise that they hear in the background, and what they describe it as is a child's padding on the wall. So imagine like a child walking on the wall. And to do that, I took two just standard paintbrushes, and if you tap them against the door frame that I made, it sort of creates that light padding sound, an airy sound that it's light like a child. It's not too heavy, but it's still not a possible sound because you can't walk on a wall. And so what this door does is it's a logical sound. We didn't need to go out of our way to recreate those door sounds. There's a very plausible explanation for everything they're hearing. And one last sound effect that I'll show is a crash. When they're trying to think of why it might be haunted, they go back into the estate's history and they find that the former owner, he died on the estate when his horse-drawn carriage overturned. And in order to recreate that sound, I've found a whole bunch of miscellaneous materials and put them in a box. And what's in here, there's plastic BBs, metal BBs, shards of wood, shards of metal, even a chain link. And when you drop it, it all just runs together and makes that nice, sort of, this unorganized crashing sound. And beneath my table, I have a plastic bucket, just a standard 4 gallon bucket, and I'll hit the table, I'll hit the bucket, and then I'll hit the floor, and that'll create a thump, 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 sort of the multi-tiered, just crashing and turning over sound that you might expect from a vehicle crashing. So I'll demonstrate that. So once again, it's very loud, it's very deep, and it's very rich at the same time because it has so many elements just rushing together to create the sound I'm looking for. So after doing this project and comparing it with the digital sound design that I've been focusing mostly on in the past, I've come to determine that each one works in its own way. For a play like I did in the fall, 1X, which is very technically intricate, fully sound designed would not have worked. Because there's one cue, for example, where it's over 35 different sound effects piled on top of each other. And I wouldn't have been able to do that. I would have needed a team of 30 people working with me and a table about the length of the stage just to get all the sound effects lined up and played at the same time. And that really isn't practical. However, for this one, where it's one at a time, it works. Because, again, it's logical explanations. There's nothing crazy about anything you're hearing. So you can think, maybe they're not hearing a haunting after all. Maybe it's a very logical explanation. But I think for this project, it's really opened up my eyes as a sound designer because now I've seen both sides. There's digital and there's live. And I can say, which works better for this? Which works better for this? And how can I make this my own? And I think that through this project, because I've been able to build it and design it for myself instead of just finding someone else's sound effect, I really have been able to make my own. Thank you.
so charming, so warming, how charming I feel, and so pretty, that I hardly can believe I'm free. See the pretty girl in that mirror there, look at that attractive girl be. Such a pretty face, such a pretty dress, such a pretty smile, such a pretty me. I feel stunning and entrancing, feel like running and dancing for joy. I feel dizzy, I feel sunny, I feel fizzy and fun.
Just Are you nervous?
Yes.
It's gonna be okay.
Signature program and showcases their talents and abilities. During the course of the day, we will be presenting the visual and performing arts work that they have produced this year. This concert is a sampling of the performances created by the performing arts. They are going to, during the course of the whole day, present their full body of work, but each concert will be a selection of their pieces. So every concert today will be different than the other ones. So I hope you thoroughly enjoy today's concert, and thank you very much.
Thank you.
saying this out of spite. Maybe I do these things to cope with sleeping alone each night. But obviously I'm still thinking of you and wishing that we could just start anew.
Thank you.
sound design in particular, in addition to lighting design and set design for technical theater. And two versions that I've been looking at are digital sound design, where you're looking online for sound effects on your computer to program into a program, versus live sound design, where you create your own sound effects to match the sounds that you're trying to create for your show. And the way that live sound design started was really back when they didn't have computers. And when you needed to recreate, you know, the sound of rocks falling, you drop a series of rocks, because that's pretty much as close as you can get. And so I became involved personally this winter when in January I went to the Maryland State Thespian Conference, and I took a class on live Foley sound design. And I thought, well, this could be a really interesting project to explore to contrast the digital sound design I've been working solely in the past. And so I took The Haunting of Hill House, which is a play that was adapted from the stage by F. Andrew Leslie, and is based off the short story by Shirley Jackson. And what it is, it's characters are in a haunted mansion, but they never fully understand what the haunting is or whether it's actually real. So I thought the live sound design could complement that notion that it may not be a ghost. It may just be something completely logical, or maybe they're actually just all insane. So right now I'll be demonstrating a few of the sounds I created for that soundscape. So one of the first is that it's, as all haunted house stories, it's always on a stormy night. And so one thing I did was to create wind. I created this wind machine. And what it is beneath this fabric, it's a series of 2x4s on a cylinder. And when I twist it with a crank, they rub against this fabric. There's a cotton polyester blend and then a nylon on top. And as they rub, the 2x4s, they create friction with the fabric, and that creates the whirring sound that you're about to hear. And so I like that because it was high-pitched, and it was sort of a cold, biting wind that I felt matched the aura of a haunted house on a cold, dark night. Another thing for the environment was rain. And one thing that a lot of people do for rain is they'll take BB pellets and pour it onto something. And so I was deciding, do I go with plastic or metal BB pellets? And ultimately what I decided was to drop plastic BB pellets onto a metal paint tray where you put paint for a paint roller. And this is what that sounds like. In the paint tray, there are these bumps that you usually use to roll paint on. And as the BBs roll down, they either bump over the bumps or jump between them, and it creates that effect of rain either hitting the roof or crashing against the windows. And it really helps add to, again, the environment of the haunted house. Another thing for the environment is thunder. And a common practice is to take a piece of galvanized sheet metal, which I have here, and to hit it. And so one thing I looked at was different drum heads or drumsticks that would change the sound the way I wanted it. And so ultimately what I decided on was this padded head, because it wasn't too hard. It sort of dampens it, which gives you the lower booming sound effect that you think of when you think of thunder. So I'll demonstrate that. And so that creates the booming, the crash, that really scares people when you think about haunted house. And I like that because it really, with the rain and the wind, it really added to that environment of, I don't necessarily want to be here because there's a ghost. And another sound effect that I had was for a door. And when I came to the door, there really wasn't much need to reinvent the wheel. So what we did was we found a door in the shop that we weren't using, and we just cut it down and built a frame for it. So that lets us make any sounds from door knocking, which they hear several times throughout the play, or the ominous door slamming. Another sound effect that they have with the building is that they describe a child's padding around the door, like footsteps sideways on the wall. And so to recreate that, I took two paintbrushes, just standard paintbrushes, and just tap them around the edge. So it gets that light, airy feeling of a child, but in a way that doesn't make sense because you can't walk on a wall. And so what that does is it's a sound that doesn't make sense because it's not physically possible, and that helps us with how is this haunting working, and is it even real? And so the last sound effect I'll showcase is a crashing sound. When they're describing perhaps why the house is haunted, they go into the history of the house, and a former owner had died when his horse-drawn wagon had turned over on his way to the house on the estate. And so to recreate a crashing sound, I just threw a bunch of things into a box, really. What's in here, there's metal BBs, plastic BBs, shards of metal, shards of wood. There's a chain link that we found. And so you put it all in and drop it, and you get that crashing sound when everything runs together. And so underneath my table, I also have just a 4-gallon plastic hollow bucket. And when I hit it on the table, it'll hit the bucket, hit the floor, and be the thump, thump, thump. Sort of like if a bunch of things are falling over. So I'll demonstrate that. And so what that does, like I said, just everything rushing together, it sort of creates that mayhem of something turning over. It sort of explains the violence in the way this guy died and maybe why he's haunting this estate. So after going through this project, I really thought about how this compares to digital sound design. And each one works in its own way. For some plays, this will work better, and for some, digital will work better. For this one, I liked it because, like I said, they don't ever come to terms with what the haunting is. They never figure it out. So these are all logical explanations for what they're hearing, what they're seeing. However, for one of the plays I did in the fall, which is one of the ones I'll show again for my digital design, this would have not worked because there's one cue where there's about 35 different sound effects layered on top of each other. And there's no way I could have done that all in succession. I would have needed a crew of 30 people on a table just about the length of the stage to put all the sound effects. But this one, for this play, works very well. And I think that going through this process has made me look at sound design differently, because it's not just what can I find online and download. It's what can I make, and how can I make this my own. Thank you.
Mama, I ain't got time for that. That's just gonna have to wait a while.
Thank you.